Hi, I am Coach Christian. I just arrived 2 days ago from Korea, where I was in a training set of Coach Kim. And as I promised last time, if I would go to Korea, I would post a couple of videos on Korean traditional archery. So I made a couple of videos with Coach Kim. And I just would like to show you the material we use. At the school, you have two kinds of bows. One is a practice bow, which has a lot of different poundages. For the beginners, just 25 pounds, goes up to 60 pounds. And the other one is a competition bow, which is made out of horn and wood. The practice bow is made out of carbon and wood. I have seen a couple of people participating in competition with a practice bow. It's a very good, very nice and soft to draw bow. It's from Kaya. The bow we buy is from Kaya. It comes in a nice bag like this here with a strap. Really nice done. The bow comes like in a sleeve. This sleeve ends up being the quiver. You just wrap it around your waist and then you just tuck in here like this your arrows. As you will see in the videos, you will see Kim Won-ho is an eighth dan in traditional Korean archery. He will be demonstrating the shooting and the technique. So, you have the bow, it looks like this here. It's unstrung. If you have the traditional carbon and this is a carbon and wood bow, if you have the horn and wood bow, it's lot more in a C form, a lot more closer. If you go back in my videos from 2011, there is a video showing how to strung, to put the strings on a, a traditional bow made out of horn and wood. This year it's very easier to put the strings on. It's very simple. You just go here, you put, and like a normal bow, you strung it. So you have it with a string. You just need to check if the limbs are nicely aligned and you're ready to go. As you will see, it's like holding the bow and you pull the string. On a traditional archer will pull the string with thumb rings. There are a couple of different ones. Here I have one made of horn, the same sort made out of plastic, and one made out of brass. Sometimes come some sleeves out of leather, not this one, some different sleeves. Those sleeves are used to fit that thumb ring better on your finger. You hold the thumb ring like here and the string will be on this part, so you hold and you pull on your thumb string. I don't like those thumb rings very much. It's very traditional, as you can see here, different forms. I like very much this one here. This one goes like here and you hold it here. So you just go in here and you pull it, the string, like this here. Okay, this is a 45 pound bow. You have actually two kinds of arrows that I used there. So as you can see, the points are bold. They are not meant to stay stuck in the target. They just hit and fall off. And when you shoot, and there are more shooters in the shooting line, for each target up to 7 shooters, you will shoot one arrow, then you wait, the next one shoots one arrow, and so on, until all seven or five, how many are in the shooting line, have shot all the arrows, and then the first one starts again. You shoot ends of five arrows, three ends on each target, and then you move on to the next target. Again, you shoot five ends, and then on the third target, more five ends. In a total, you shoot three times five arrows on each target. It means you shoot 45 arrows in a total in a competition. In training use, you stay just on one target and you shoot. If you have only two archers, you shoot, the other shoots, and then you shoot, and the other shoots, and so on. The reason is because those arrows, they don't get stuck in the target. They just hit and fall off. While you're practicing in the center by Coach Kim, there's a light behind the target. So when it hits the target, the light goes on. This here is a carbon aluminium arrow, competition arrow. It's a 340 grain arrow. It's practically an ACC arrow. This here is a carbon XL from Easton, also 340 grain, just plain carbon. It's a practice arrow. You have also very traditional arrows there made out of bamboo wood. I just use those two arrows. Very nice arrows to shoot. So, I hope you will enjoy it. This first video will be about how to start shooting. As you will be seeing, there is a pole. It's around 4 or 5 meters high, and there's a string on that pole. That string is attached to the front part of the arrow, and you take a very light bow, like a 25-pound bow. You go on and you shoot using the technique. The arrow is stuck to that string. It just will go around that pole and fall near your foot. So you don't need to go there to pick arrows, and you don't need to make wrong shots. Maybe they fall too short or too far away, or they fall in the lake. There's a big lake in front of the targets at the center. So for you to avoid to need to try to catch the arrows from the lake, is this practice place where you have a pole, a string, on an arrow, and you just keep on shooting until you get practice on how holding the bow correctly, how pull the bow correctly, angle of your arm, your foot stance, your foot position, your body position. After you had enough practice and you have a good feeling of shooting, and after you are able to pull a little heavier bow, you go on for the shooting line to do your first shots at 145 meters. So, I hope you enjoy this video.
Arrow is this position, right? Next. Right. This hooking. Okay, right. Set up. Right. More higher. Already in front of the bow. Drawing. is good. It's perfect. Right? Drawing, aiming with?
Yeah.
With what? This one. Okay. Number two. More, not enough, more, all drawing, full drawing, more, right.
Yes?
Ah, 옷이 너무 잘 어울린다.